day, everyone. Rob Helean with your Asian session preview for Tuesday, May the 18th, 2010. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. Please be advised the purpose of FX Bootcamp is education. It is not an alert service. Coaches will not make any trade recommendations. However, we will conduct technical and fundamental analysis of the live markets and help you construct trade plans throughout the course of your trading day. Please bear in mind when trading heavily leveraged, it's a very risky business. Therefore, prior to any form of live trading, we'd like to ensure you have a successful track record using your broker's demo account. Okay, guys. Little Euro made history during Asia last night. We had a pretty good Asia session. And we are currently living in this 120 low 123 region. And we saw some new lows we haven't seen for over 4 years through here. And now we're back in this April 2006 zone. In terms of lows, and you can't help but think, just looking on this weekly naked chart on the euro, that maybe the next stop for this is this nice round level here of 120. Another 370 pips from where we're at right now as we speak, just where I'm drawing this dotted line. I think logically, as we're traders, now we've broken 125 and we're heading down into the 123s, 122s even, that we did in Asia last night. Psychologically, maybe 120 is eventually where we're going to come to our next port of call. So let's just think about it quickly. Let's just think through how we might get there on this euro this week, and let's think how we can do this with where we'd find bulls and bears in this current market, and how we can maybe do it conservatively without getting ourselves into too much trouble. I do like to use pivot points in these sorts of situations. Now let's just go to the Euro USD weekly pivots on the 4-hour chart. I just want to highlight for you. Been in this downtrend for a better part of a month now. You see this central pivot? If it's making lower lows every week after week, you can consider that we're in a downtrend. You see a central pivot doing this sort of thing, you're in some serious downtrend activity. The other thing to note, and this is where I'm getting to with this video, is nearly every week we like to come back to our central pivot and then continue short. A little bit above it last week, but no big deal. I can't help but think I have this on, at least in the back of my mind, or definitely on my radar screen, a visitation back up into the central pivot region on the weekly, before we might find our little trip down to 120. And lo and behold, look at 120, right at our weekly support pivots. What a week. If we could get to a central pivot down to 120 for the week, what a nice week that would be on this euro. If that's the high-level trade plan for the week, you know, how can we play this out today? Well, just as I speak to you now, I'm just going to drill down. That was weekly pivots on a 4-hour chart. This is the daily pivots on an hourly chart. Let me just highlight a few things for you. I'm just going to scroll across a little bit here. This area up here, 2 weeks ago, weekly central pivot, resistance pivots. You can build short trade plans off there, below a central pivot, and then we just hopped into our, you know, traveled short below a central pivot until we got to last Monday, above the central pivot, up to resistance M4 pivots again. This here, guys, this is that pullback to the weekly central. Exactly what I'm looking for again, maybe now, before we get further downside. That's where I'm getting to here. So what am I looking for? Well, I'm going to be looking for something along these lines if I just get back to today's price action. We drove price down quite nicely in Asia yesterday. Asia was basically a continuation of Friday. Well, that gave Europe, and as we can see now, New York No option but to go buying. One thing you'll find in these markets, guys, if Asia trades you for whatever reason on a pair two extremes, pivots or any forms of support or resistance, Europe is going to be forced to come in and reverse the market. They are not going to, very rarely are you going to see them continue shorting. It's a way cheaper option for them to buy. And that's exactly what we saw here in Europe, very much a counter trend trading day, New York, and once again, we're counter trend trading our way up as well. Well, in a few hours' time, we're going to get some new pivots. Going to look something like this. New central is going to come down. These might even be slightly up. Okay, it's been a rather, you know, low average daily range day. These pivots will probably come down a little bit. Well, I'm wondering whether we can get price to be live above the central pivot and then pull back to the central, and then we can get long. And our trade plans can be longing off daily central pivot regions up to this little value here, which I think hopefully could be, say, an R between R2, which is here, and the daily M4, which is here, because that 126 value, folks, is the weekly central pivot. And we're going to see a repeat, basically a rinse and repeat of what happened last week. Price is in a general trend, long-term trend, breaks a central, goes to extreme pivots, finds resistance, I think this was a 618 in this case, and then continue the trend. Well, that's exactly what I want to see now, and I'm hoping that we can get long into these central, into these extreme pivots around 126, even maybe a little bit higher up to that 200 EMA, like we did last week, and then look to short again. If I throw Mr. Fibonacci up, is bang smack in between a 382 to 50% Fib of last week's price action. What better place to build short trade plans if we can get up there? Okay, so the theme of the day, guys, is we're going to use pivot points as our proxy. If we can open price and come off a central pivot to the upside, we're going to use that as support and see if we can trade our way up to this 126 region, then looking for shorts. It's going to be the next main area of bears, and see if we can get this down. Eventually, maybe we'll keep you updated. We might give that 120 a little visit at some stage. Have yourselves a good trading day, and we'll catch you later. Cheers.